Detective Bernie Jacob. I, in conjunction with my partner, Detective Jim McHugh, are the crime prevention coordinators for the New York City Transit Police Department. Graffiti, as the name itself, is not an art. Graffiti is the application of a medium to a surface.
I don't really want to be the father of graffiti because it's not a noble child to have. As far as being the father of graffiti, I think they give me that name because it's a very basic graffiti. It's not unique. It stood out from other similar graffiti. And that's the only reason. And as I said, the media propped it up. They made the Taki Awards, you know, all kinds of things. The funny story is, when we were first starting out, we were in an elevator and we killed the elevator. And there was a regular person there. And when we got to the bottom of the elevator, there was a policeman there. And he goes to the policeman and he says, "Look, these guys just vandalized the whole elevator." And the cop didn't do anything. He kind of like, "Yeah, so?" He didn't realize, you know, he had like all the top guys he could have caught. As far as being an unwilling father, the interesting thing is I've met a lot of people who said, I'm not being egotistical, but they said, I changed their lives, which I find amazing. But I think, I don't know why. Things happen for a reason if it's the time for them to take off. After I stopped writing in the 80s, it was very sloppy. If you went in the subway, it was terrible. People were writing one on top of the other for no apparent reason. Because when I started, I was writing very small and there was a blank wall. Then the next person would write bigger and bigger. But as it got bigger, it got more stylized. And the cream of the writers rose above it, the real artists. The subway was a large part of the spread of graffiti because it went to a lot of different neighborhoods. And the kids who wanted to get up and be popular, that was the most popular way to get around. Just like kids in the Midwest from very small towns, they'll go right on trains, and those go all over the country. So it's just a smaller world. When Julio 204 was writing, nobody else was really writing. And we didn't know it was a person. We thought something was going to happen in July 20th at 4 o'clock. But after a while, we realized it was a person. And we said, oh, everybody knows the name, but nobody knows who he is. We'll do the same thing. We'll be anonymous, but everybody will know us. Yeah, that was part of the great fun of it, to be a celebrity that nobody knows. I think the only one who's still doing that is Banksy. Nobody knows who he is, but he's very popular. In the modern graffiti, I don't know if you can call it graffiti anymore, because graffiti is something you do secretly. In my mind, you do it. I did it not to be known, for the anonymity of it. Greeks would know that Taki was short for Dimitraki. And that's what my mother called me. Everybody called me that. The only thing I chose was the 183, I guess in respect to Julio 204. I decided to put my street. A lot of people meet me or they see me after a lot of years because nobody saw my face for about 40 years. I've gone to graffiti signing or whatever, and people meet me and they say, "Oh, that was you?" You know, I don't know what they expected. Sometimes I feel I should have stayed anonymous. But, you know, it's a long time since I did it, and I guess I want to satisfy some people's curiosity. Once I stopped, I didn't really have the impulse to go back. As far as graffiti being illegal, I guess there has to be some protection for private property. I know a lot of younger people, you know, they get arrested, they do community service, they have to pay fines. So, you know, I hate to call it a crime. I guess I'd like to say that there should be some places where kids can go and write on the walls without having to look over their shoulders, basically. Because even the garage here, I was thinking of doing the outside with nice art, but you may have trouble with the city. They may say it's going to attract more artists writing where it's not wanted. So I don't think it's really accepted mainstream. I'd like Baki to be remembered just as somebody who did something not great, but maybe something great came out of it in the end. And I have to tell you that this graffiti movement has lasted a lot longer than some other art movements. So I think that speaks for itself. The last time I did graffiti was in Greece, in Athens, where I guess it's called the Crew Buns Crew, used to meet. Spike 69, everybody knows them there. And that was this year. So you can't take the graffiti out of somebody.